Hi everyone, Mark Twining here, account manager at Curo Talent. I'm standing here with John Davies, one of our top Microsoft experts in Always On VPN and infrastructure. Thought we'd have a quick chat while we've got a break about Always On VPN and talk about some of the challenges and some of the benefits of the products. John, first question for you. Can you tell us a bit about some of the benefits of Always On VPN compared to some other VPNs in the marketplace?
Yeah, absolutely. Traditionally, over the years, customers have often used things like Checkpoint VPN or Blue Coat proxies. And obviously, with the advent of Windows 10 and Always On VPN, it's a free product outside the box with Windows 10.
Yep.
Therefore, it's obviously cost saving, you know, it's always on. It means that the user doesn't have to click any icons to make a connection, unlike the traditional VPNs that we've got with Checkpoint and Blue Coat and other vendors.
Okay, and what about sort of compatibility and, you know, IPv? I've, you know, heard that there's some strides been made versus, you know, direct access and things like that.
Yeah, absolutely. So direct access was the predecessor to Always On VPN. It was IPv6 only. Yep. Of course, a lot of complexities in business and people getting an understanding of how it works. So now they've gone back to using traditional IPv4. We've got all the features of direct access in Always On VPN. So things like the ability to remotely patch the clients, which is often a big concern for customers. The no user interaction, they log on to their Windows 10 and the VPN connection is always there.
Yep.
They can also do it selectively as well. So if you just wanted an application that had to come back through over a VPN, we could do an application triggered VPN as well. But most customers like the always on because it gives them the degree of security and confidence that the device is always connected to the corporate network.
Sure, okay. And what about customers that have already invested in you know, other sort of hardware and things like that? Can you tell us a bit about sort of infrastructure independence of the product?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I've been to a lot of customers that are obviously interested in putting on always on VPN. They've got to take consideration the scale of users. So, you know, it can run on virtual or hardware servers, but they've got to take into consideration things like hardware load balancing. Because if you've got, you know, hundreds, thousands of users, you need the ability to be able to scale up and scale out. Additionally, you know, there are other things like firewalls. You need to be very considerate about the firewall rules that come in and out, the placement of the always-on VPN servers. And essentially, it's a combination of well-known Microsoft products all bolted together to build Always On VPN.
Yeah.
A lot of customers sort of forget to look at their PKI and make sure that, you know, it's fit for purpose. So there's a lot of engagements that I've been on where we may have had to do some remediation work on that.
Right.
So there's a lot to think about.
I think we've experienced this ourselves, talking to Microsoft partners and end customers around Always On VPN for the last 6 to 12 months.
Yeah.
And actually, I think what customers don't realize is the complexity of the engagements. You know, sometimes, like you say, some of these peripheral you know, technologies, some of the infrastructure itself needs preparing. There are definitely some real prerequisites to implementing it.
And then there's some of the guidelines as well. So a lot of organizations like NHS and local authorities and the central government, they need to adhere to the National Cyber Security Center guidelines. So, you know, you can't just go with a traditional split tunnel VPN. Forced tunneling VPN doesn't always suit everybody's needs. So then you've got the ability to use a managed tunnel offering from NCSC, which gives the flexibility, but also the security at the same time. And some of the key challenges that with legacy VPNs is using things like captive portals. So, you know, pay sites in hotels where you've got to pay before you get internet access. So these are other benefits that can be leveraged by Always On VPN.
Sure.
It's a great technology.
Fantastic. Great, okay, well thank you for taking that time to give us a bit of a rundown, answer some questions. I think that, you know, the key thing that we're excited about, you know, Windows 10 offers Always On VPN as a free, you know, free part of the product.
Absolutely.
You know, companies should absolutely be considering it as an alternative to some of their managed, you know, payable, you know, billable services that they're on right now in VPN. Cool.